What's good? It's your boy KG, the one that loves God, fears God, and I love the game of basketball. Shout out to the new subscribers. I just got a huge subscriber boost over the last couple days. That's what I'm talking about. Every time I looked at my phone, new subscriber. That's what I'm talking about. Shout out to the old subscribers that stuck with me since day one. Multi 5, man. My boy Samuel. Carloa. Super Slime. Super Trooper, Beast Mode, and if I forgot y'all, I apologize. It's kind of hard to remember a lot of stuff when you're driving and looking around. But yeah, I sincerely appreciate you guys, man. Hopefully one day I get enough subscribers, get enough views where I can quit my job for real and talk about basketball and God all day long, baby. That's what I love to do. This may be old news, but I cannot believe Rajon Rondo and Chris Paul, man. They wildin'. That fight didn't freaking trickle down to the wives. Like, what? The wives even fighting, having them verbal abuse on the internet and all that kind of stuff. They wildin'. They really wildin'. I'm just like, these dudes, man. And LeBron James is looking like, come on, man. It's my season, my opener, man. Yo, really? Really? I'm the king. Come on, man. Really? Really? I'm King James. Come on. But yo, for real, that's, man, that fight spoiled his home return for the Lakers. I was just like, wow. But y'all know I had the Thunder up, baby. Now let's get into it, man. Yo, am I worried about this 0-3 start? Kind of. But a part of me is saying Russ and PG and Sam Presti, I hope Billy Donovan, is not putting up with this crap for too long. For real. Now, Paul George said a couple days ago, there's no need to panic. But what is Russ saying? Russ, to me, looks kind of agitated, but he does understand the process. I mean, guys, let's really be 100% real. This was a rebuild this year. When Carmelo left, this was an absolute rebuild. We got another backed off point guard. Pretty much semi-starter in Dennis Schroeder. We got TLC, Nerlens Noel, Burton, Diallo, Nader. Dude, this is a rebuild. So that's what eased my conscience a little bit, is knowing that it's a rebuild, knowing we got new players like crazy. We really have a new Oklahoma City Thunder team. So I can't be too upset. However, I got a weird feeling that we might beat the Celtics. This is going to be Russ' second game of the season back. Now, a lot of people are like, stop jumping the guns. Kev, I know that's what y'all thinking, baby. I know that's what y'all thinking. But I guarantee you, I ain't going to say guarantee, but 9 out of 10 of me is saying we're going to beat the Celtics. It's like when we play against teams that we know are good, it's a whole different mindset. But my thing is, if Oklahoma City Thunder can get this through their head for everybody, playing the mediocre teams, playing the poor teams, and playing the best teams, if we can play them the same, we will be a force to be reckoned with. Deadly team, baby. That's what the Oklahoma City Thunder is capable of, if you really look at them. So to be real, we are having identity issues. I believe that they all need to huddle up real quick and say, yo, who are we, baby? You know what I'm saying? Somebody spoke on this recently. And I agree. We need to find that identity. Are we going to play defense? Are we going to be beast mode team? Da, da, da. I really feel like our identity need to be beast mode, baby. Let me calm down. I'm in the truck wilding out. But that's what I feel like we can do. We got the integrity. We got the toughness. We got the tenacity, the let's get him type of attitude to be out there beasting these dudes, man. And that's what I feel like we need to do. If I'm Billy Donovan, if I'm Sam Presti, my starting lineup is going to be Russ at the 1, Diallo at the 2, PG at the 3, and I start Nerlens Noel at the 4. Yes, Nerlens Noel need to be starting at the 4 against the Celtics, and Steven Adams at the 5. Who's going back up? Put in Tyler Davis. That dude looks like he's hungry. Whenever he gets in, like the preseason or summer league and none of that. I've been watching this dude. Don't sleep on Tyler Davis, y'all. He ready. I'm telling you, it's something about these rookies, man. It's really something about these rookies. These dudes, man, I'm telling you. I don't know if it's the breast milk when they was young, the baby formula, the water they've been drinking from, I don't know. I don't care. But these young dudes is not playing no more. I mean, come on, think about it. We just got beat by a young Kings team. Young dudes, youngins in their 20s, early 20s. You know what I'm saying? Come on now, that go to tell you that this league is going in another direction, baby. Kyle Kuzma, like these young dudes. I don't know what it is about these dudes. That's why, like, yo, my oldest son, he about to be 14. I'm about to really train this dude. And I got another son behind him that's 9. I'm like, they demigods already in the height. Almost my height. I'm 6'5". For real, man. Gotta catch that wave. These young dudes these days, man, they really coming out balling. I'm really impressed with Burton as well. I don't speak, I need to be speaking about him as much as I do Diallo, because he's the diamond in the rough of the team. I'm telling you, man, he got the build of a Draymond Green, 6'5", straight muscle, and the dude is not scared. The dude is raw. He's raw. So I'm just hoping that Billy Donovan and them really get it through their head, man. Better sign that man to a regular contract and let him play. Deontay Burton need to be seeing at least 15 to 20 minutes a game. At least. Like, the dude, man, I can't, like, what else can I say, man? The dude is a beast. He hasn't proved me wrong yet. Yet. So, only time can tell what's going to happen, guys. Like I said, I'm not really too much worried. Let's remember that these new pieces, these new acquisitions to the team, It's a straight rebuild. And we got to keep that through our heads, man. Let's not panic. Let's see what's going to happen. I don't know if they're going to fire Billy. I don't know what's going to happen. The trade, I don't know. So let's just see what's going to happen, man. Y'all be blessing the Lord. Always remember, keep God first and everything else is going to fall into place. I'm going to leave y'all with a quick word of the day. Focus. Don't lose focus, man. There's a lot of distractions out here, and you gotta always remember, keep your eye on the prize. Whatever you set your mind to, keep chasing after it. Don't let nobody stop you. Any distraction is an enemy. Always remember that. If it's something that's taking your eyes off of the prize, cut it off. Let's go, baby. Y'all be blessing the Lord. Peace.